It's something I really aspire to achieve maybe someday. And but again, I want to talk mostly as a son and mention how grateful I am to have a Jay as a father who's very dedicated to his kids, very attentive and involved with them, has always been. And he's also one of the most generous and cultured people that I know. So I want to be very brief. I'll just let the slides do the rest of the talking for me. But I really want to thank you for everything. Might go by a little quickly, so if anyone later wants to tell a story related to one particular picture, we can set it up to. Hope you enjoy this.
Fall is here, hear the yell, back to school, ring the bell, brand new shoes, walking blues, climb the fence. And pens, I can tell that we are gonna be friends. I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Walk with me, Susie Lee, through the park and by the tree. We will rest upon the ground and look at all the bugs we found. Safely walk to school without a sound. Sound. Here we are, no one else. We walk to school all by ourselves. There's dirt on our uniforms from chasing all the ants and worms. We clean up and now it's time to learn. We clean up and now it's time to learn. Numbers, letters, learn to spell. Nouns and books and show and tell. Playtime, we will throw the ball back to class, through the hall. Teacher marks our height against the wall. Teacher marks our height against the wall. We don't notice any time pass. We don't notice anything. Sit side by side in every class. Teacher thinks that I sound funny, but she likes the way you sing. Tonight I'll dream while I'm in bed, when silly thoughts go through my head about the bugs and alphabet. When I wake tomorrow, I'll bet that you and I will walk together again. I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Yes, I can tell. California rain is falling. I can hear the summer calling. Far away, far away. The song that's fading. Put me on a plane tomorrow. I'll try to run from all my sorrow. Far away. Moving
from where my heart is.
Okay, so now whoever wants to share a story of Jair with the others, any volunteer?
Ariel.
We'll come back.
So probably everybody who knows Jair has always thought of him as being fun. So in 1988, in the cold, snowy Ithaca, New York, we were having a conference about geometric phase, a workshop, and when Jair's turn came to speak, he handed out postcards of women on Ipanema. Do you remember? And he said, "I just want to show you what my country is like. And you're welcome to come and visit." And one of the first few people who were looking at these postcards as he was passing them out, and I've forgotten who now, said, "Can I have this?"
Anyway, your words can be in Portuguese, Spanish, English, you know, doesn't matter.
Well, I first met Jair not that long after I joined the faculty at Berkeley. And so it was really flattering to me to have somebody want to work with somebody who practically just got there and didn't really know what he was doing to advise students. Fortunately, I had somebody who was a real self-starter, although he needed a push now and then. He was in a cohort of two, the other of whom is sitting down the aisle there, Yilmaz Akildiz, who arrived the same year, or within a year, and they finished together. Over the years, Jair has followed his own directions very much, despite my efforts occasionally to push him into more abstract things. I'm very proud of the fact that he has accomplished many things in directions which I would have liked to have gone myself. Over the years, I have this periodic wish to return to practical, so to speak, applications of mathematics. And now and then I delve into such things. Some number of years ago, I was actually doing something that I thought of as being plasma physics. And that's when I met Daryl, for example. I learned really that I wasn't doing any of those sorts of things. I was just finding in those subjects mathematics that was interesting to me. But Jair, on the other hand, has in addition to having real mathematical insight, has seen really how these rather abstract ideas can be used. And I think Kurt's talk was an example of the really down-to-earth, or maybe one should say down-to-water, applications that can be done with geometric mechanics. In a talk this morning, I asked a question about this Riemannian curve, curve smoothing or curve matching. The speaker, Fatima, I think is her name, showed two pictures of Jair at 20 years apart and gave the formula for how to interpolate between them. And I expressed disappointment that she didn't, at the end, show a movie of that. But I'm very glad that Jose was able to provide it, not only interpolating, but also extrapolating, at least in one direction. I am still disappointed that we don't see the next 10 years of photos of Jair up on the screen. So happy birthday, Jair.
I'm going to speak in Portuguese because I'm a little emotional and the Portuguese is better for me. Jairo foi uma pessoa que mais me influenciou na minha formação de graduação. A gente tinha encontros todas as quintas-feiras para um almoço para discutir matemática. Foi meu orientador de iniciação científica no primeiro momento, onde eu aprendi geometria, topologia algébrica e muito mais coisas. Ele foi tão influenciador para a gente, eu e mais alguns colegas, que sem nunca ter dado aula, ele foi paraninfo da nossa turma na formatura. Foi a primeira homenagem que acho que ele teve na universidade. Foi nosso colega na universidade, até vir uma aposentadoria cedíssima, eu acho que é cedíssima. Ele vive falando que vai retornar da aposentadoria e voltar a ser professor da universidade. Quem sabe ele se convence a fazer isso de novo, pela contribuição que sempre dá na formação dos estudantes. Jair, muito obrigado porque você fez eu virar geômetra, tenho certeza disso. E se eu tenho só alguma coisa que gosta dessa área, a influência da graduação veio de você naqueles almoços que a gente tinha lá no Moscão, na UFRJ, toda quinta-feira para comer e falar de matemática. Muito obrigada.
So according to the chairman, I'm going to speak now. This is it's geodesic, perhaps. Okay. So Jair, it's incredible to be here with you today. Derek just referred to the 88 handling of postcards. After that, 4 years later, I was arriving at IMPA just after my PhD in Berkeley. And back then, I used it to do Hamiltonian mechanics a little bit. And Jair convinced me to organize a conference here in Rio. I remember Tudor came, Deb came, a few other people who are here. Oh, you came. So the conference was a real success, and it was very, very touching for me because it got me hooked in organizing conferences. And a few years later, Jair managed to convince me to organize a series of mathematical meetings together with some other people on biomathematics. It's called the Mathematical Modeling of Biophysical Phenomena. And this is amazingly important both for my career as well as for the career of many students. We have examples of students who are probably here who came as young undergrads to our conferences, and they were participating, and they are now full-grown researchers. Greg Huber came for one of the first meetings. I think Kurt also came to a few meetings, and I invite you all for the next one. It's going to happen next year, and no handling of postcards. I don't think we need that anymore. On the personal side, I had many contributions from Jair, and both as stimulus for, you know, keeping on doing some weird things that I was thinking about, in particular when I kind of left a little bit the more abstract side of the world to doing more applied things. He used it to come to my financial math seminars too. Then, every once in a while, I get an invitation, a crazy invitation, and I don't know if José is going to be fast enough to get the picture that he showed us in Udmurtia in Russia. And many Russians don't even know where it is, but Jay is capable of doing these things, of getting people very far, but very motivated to do things. And I think this is one of his wonderful characteristics of motivating people to do and explore new avenues. So Jay, thank you very much for everything that you did for my personal experience as a researcher, and also for all our students that you helped. Thank you.
Hi. I'm going to talk a little bit more about Jair's ability to motivate. I was postdocing back east and kind of lonely, and Jair was trying to get us excited on geometric phases and the swimming. And what I remember is he's very good with presents. And he showed up to our house with presents. My wife didn't know him, but he gives his presents and says, "We're going to be friends for a long time. Here's these presents. Just understand that." I said, what do you do? And many years later, to Jair's disappointment, I started working in celestial mechanics, and the work went pretty well. And he was working with Kurt, and he wanted me to keep on the team. And he would visit me in Santa Cruz, and I just wanted to do celestial mechanics. I said, "Maybe I will work with you for half a day. They drive a long ways. They come visit me." He comes. My daughter has a little dog, Raina, is running back and forth. And he looks at me and Kurt, and he says, "You know, if Richard won't write a paper with us, we'll have Raina be a co-author." So those are my jokes.
Hello, I'm Yılmazak Yıldız. I'm, I think, Alan's oldest student, if not the first. And Jair and I don't know how we met, but Jair is somebody who will come to you. Even if you hesitate, he will not miss you. I came a long way to be here. I'm very happy to be here. And I know that I would become very emotional, so I wrote a few things I like to read off. I'm sorry for reading from my notes, because I know that I will not be able to tell what I want to tell if I leave it to myself. Well, I will also take this opportunity to thank Alan Weinstein. I cannot separate him from us. So my notes say, two very dear people to me in my life, A.W. and J.K. In his 2003 book review, which touches every aspect of life except football, from Mark Twain, Jair quotes on a bit of exaggeration. In Turkish, we do it more than a bit and cover ourselves with a proverb, "No mistakes done on comparison." I wouldn't like to embarrass my friends, but I will read it anyway, what I wrote, what I came to my hands. Well, "no mistakes done on comparison," Otherwise, there would be no literature. So I'm allowed to... exaggerate because they deserve it. Well, one is orientable, the other non-orientable. One is introverted, the other multiverted, together making a perfect symplectic team. Both with no sharp edges or singularities, but carrying lots of information and wisdom, always ready to share, they are right here with us now. The orientable one is like a glowing, radiating out, shining ball with almost no information sent out about inside. A conserved quantity and mostly shy, but infinitely open to outside when it comes to sharing mathematics. How can we forget the symplectic lunches? I once introduced him to an Istanbul audience as, here is a man born as mathematician. The other, non-orientable one. There is no inside nor outside, all the same, and transparent all the way. Cloud of warmth, knowledge, care and carefulness flow out of him, always trying to reach further, as far as possible, to as many people as possible. I'm not surprised at that he has so many collaborators and he had so many students he helped with. He's a radical in all aspects, but meanwhile an extreme pacifist. If you ask me, he is the Gandhi of this land. I'm not exaggerating, by the way. I was very lucky to be at Berkeley during the first half of the 70s. I have been very much enriched and helped by both of my manifolds, orientable and non-orientable. It is a great pleasure for me now to be sharing them with you here today. Going back to the beginning of my talk, today's talk, 10 years ago, Jair did not only review a book, but he touched many parts of related mathematics, and through it, he shared with us his life philosophy. I now feel that it is our right to expect Jair make similar 10-yearly reviews into a periodic motion. Thank you.
Jair and I go back to the early 80s. I finished at Berkeley in 1980. And I used to come back over the summers or whenever we had some vacation to talk to Jerry and to Alan. Those were the heydays of physics applications. And Jair showed up as a postdoc at the time, as a visitor. And ever since we have been very, very close. I mean, he became a very, very close family friend. I can remember many dinners at our house, in Berkeley and then in Santa Cruz and all over the place. I want to make just two comments. First of all, I want to say a few things just to give you the atmosphere of what Daryl was talking about. You see, Daryl simply said very nicely, yes, we were at Cornell. But you have to understand that Cornell is in the middle of nowhere. I mean, if you, right, we were all there. Tony just arrived, right? It was a dreary winter. It was absolutely terrible, right? You had nowhere to go. The whole town has two streets, right? You know, it's the same restaurant all over, all the time, the same thing, right? And, you know, it was one of those winters where, you know, it was wet, humid, cold, and we organized this meeting. So here comes Jair and shows us these pictures. You know, it had quite an effect on us. And I dare say that the success of the conference, right, had to do with those pictures because they remained engraved in our head, you know, after this Cornell experience when Jair very modestly said, well, you know, I all invite you, and this is the this is the landscape that you will see in Rio. another occurrence was recently at Caltech, after the disappearance of our friend Jerry Marsden. I went there to arrange some of his affairs. And Jair was there also. So he was teaching, I was teaching certain things. And to this day, it remains a mystery. You're going to laugh at this, I had a working accident. I bent to pick up a piece of paper, and I remained bent. to this day, I don't know what it was. It probably was a virus or something, but the pain was absolutely excruciating. I managed eventually to get myself in a vertical position, and the only way I could function was vertical. Now, you can stand or you can lie down, but how do you get from this position to that position and backwards, right? Because there was no way to move, right? In this predicament, Jair came to the rescue. He said, look, I'll take you to the doctor, right? And he drove me regularly to the doctor on the working accident for which Caltech paid everything. It went away exactly as it came. And it was the first time I understood what back pain is. But man, Jair was very optimistic. Don't worry, Tudor, it'll go away. Don't worry. It was typically Jair. Nothing could perturb him. Don't worry. We are optimistic. It'll work. Just don't worry. It's okay. Thank you very much, Jair, for your friendship.
Oh, I'd like to. Well, when did I meet Jair first? I was an undergraduate student in PUC, and he was around. He wasn't a professor there, but he was always around. And maybe a very nice talk about some geometric mechanics. I don't know. I went to Berkeley to study topology in the early 80s, and I quickly found out that subject was not a good idea to get into it. It was a bit past its time. I learned about symplectic geometry through announcements in the talks in the corridors, and got really fascinated by this mixture of mechanics and mathematics. I went to work with Alan, so back in the 80s, and then I didn't realize that Jair had been a student of Alan. So I found out, of course, he would pass by Berkeley, and eventually we found out about it, and you went on as it goes. But when we came back to Brazil in 92, Jair was one of the people who actually helped us a lot in the beginning. He tried to get us a job. He actually asked for a grant to bring both me and Elena to Rio to work at LNCC. And that didn't work. We ended up going to Campinas. But we kept in touch always. I'm pretty sure that I was always a bit frustrating for Jair, but in the same way that Alan tried to get Jair back into the more abstract side of things, he always tried to pull me back into the geometric mechanics, and without success. I suspect that he's always a bit frustrated with me because of that. And I've actually felt tempted into going and getting a little bit more geometry in my life by working with Jair, but you know, it never worked out. But we always talked. His talks have always been an inspiration. Over the many subjects that he's worked on, geometric, I was absolutely fascinated with the geometric phases, which was what he was into when I got back to Brazil. Then this biology work became very interesting. And funny enough, the vortices work, the more recent work of Jair, comes much closer to what I actually do, which is fluid dynamics. These days, so we actually get together. We often invite each other to conferences and that we are organizing and so on. So we actually kept into professional touch in this distant way. It's always been very pleasant to be around Jair. He's an incredibly generous person. Every time there is a new project, a new idea, he donates all of his time and his heart with a generosity that I find astounding. I don't think I've ever seen anyone quite like that. And he has this way, this smooth way about himself that you talked about, that's a mixture of Berkeley and Rio in an interesting way, non-trivial sort of way, I'd say. Recently, we've had a somewhat difficult visitor that's a friend of Jair, but he's working with us. And Jair has been incredible helping us take care of this difficult visitor. In the past few weeks, I'm extremely thankful to Jair for that, in fact. But for all the interaction over the years, Jair, for the many, for the inspirational lectures, for the conversations, for everything, thank you very much. It's been a pleasure to be in the same subject as you are.
I'm Hildeberto Cabral. I have been a friend of Jair since many years ago, from the times of PUC, Pontificia Universidade Católica, where we met the first time. He was a student in the calculus courses. and later, we were doing graduate studies, but in the same time in Berkeley, and we were always sharing dinner at my house, his house, doing voyaging. Yosemite, other places, I want to thank Jair now for his contribution to the group in Celestial Mechanics in Recife, in Northeast in general, now Aracaju, and he's always the disposition to help and with his generosity promoting and right now we are starting a program for in the Science Without Frontier that CAPS has and with Richard Montgomery and Jair asked me to whether it would be okay to include the Northeast, and so I want to thank him for not only for this present time, but for all the time in the past that we have been friends.
I don't know that there's actually a lot that I can get out because I'm actually quite overwhelmed with emotion. Jair has been my mentor and friend, and I wouldn't be where I'm at without him. I was trying to think what this, but sorry. I have a very very funny way that we've worked together for these years. Typically what will happen is Jair will tell me something, and I'll think it's just completely crazy and it can't be true. And I'm a little slower, so it takes me maybe 5 years. And then it comes back to me, and I think, he had a great idea. And I bring it back to Jair. And he says, "You're a genius. How did you ever come up with that?" It happens all the time. But Jair has been my I look up to him as a big brother, and I wouldn't be where I'm at without him.
So I just want to share a story of how I got in touch with Jair for the first time. So I was finishing up my thesis in the University of Arizona, and my advisor, Herman Flaschka, suggested to contact Jair for him to be my external advisor for my dissertation. So I wrote a formal email saying, "Dear Professor Koiller, I would really appreciate if you could be the external reviewer for my dissertation." And so what he did is he looked at my webpage at the University of Arizona. He saw my picture, and he replied in Spanish right away, saying, "Well, you look like a good mathematician, and you have the name of a good football player." And then that was just such a friendly way of starting interaction, and ever since he's been extremely supportive. And I have to say that in the name of many Latin American students of my generation, he's just been extremely warm, supportive, and encouraging, and I just want to thank him. Thank you very much.
Okay, so maybe I'll say a couple of things. Right, right. Yeah. I was trying to remember when I first met Jair. So I think I was taken to Jair by a friend that we have in common called Cassio. And this was in 1996. So a while ago, I was an undergraduate, and I was actually, I think I had been accepted to go to Berkeley as a student, and Cassio told me, I took physics one. I don't know why you were teaching physics, but you know, I took physics one from this really nice guy. I think he was a student at Berkeley. Maybe, you know, you can have a, you know, you can talk to him and he can give you tips and stuff. I said, "Oh, that sounds good." And then he took me to LNCC. And we had lunch together. Maybe you don't remember any of that. But and then in that first meeting, I remember, you know, three interactions we had back in 1996 that I think were, you know, very, you know, influential in my life. So in this first meeting, he gave me access to the library of LNCC, which was very nice because it was much closer to my house, so I didn't have to go all the way to the university. I could just, you know, hang out at LNCC. It's, you know, it used to be in Urca, you know, next to the Sugarloaf. Now it's, you know, away from Rio. It's in Petropolis. But back then was, you know, very close for me. And the library was very small, but it had like this, you know, beautiful collection of books in geometric mechanics. So all the books by Ratio and Marsden and Weinstein, you know. And I remember spending many hours in that library, you know, just studying and reading and learning some of that stuff. And this definitely helped me a lot. And every now and then I would bump into Jair and we would, you know, talk. And I also noticed that in this book by Marsden and Ratio, you know, Jair was cited in the end. And I was, you know, kind of very impressed by that. I was like, you know, this guy must have done something, you know. I mean, I said like Koiller in the end of the book. And this was the, you know, our first interaction. And then the second interaction was when Jair came to me and told me that he wanted to teach a fluid dynamics course at the university. And he needed students because no one enrolled in the course. And, you know, he needed students in order to get credit for the course, you know, teaching credit. And then, all right, and then I agreed and I enrolled in that course. But not with that, you know, but first I asked Jair, so, you know, what is this course about? And then he answered in a way that also stuck to my mind somehow. He told me that, you know, first he said, you know how there are people that are completely crazy about the Beatles, you know? And then I have this image of, you know, like all these girls crying in concert and, you know, overwhelmed by emotion. And then he said, you know, I'm pretty crazy about, you know, applications of complex analysis to fluids. And then, you know, I was just imagining Jair kind of, you know, overwhelmed with emotion, you know. Oh, I applied the, you know, Riemann mapping theorem or something, you know, to fluids and crying. Anyway, so this was our second interaction. So it was a very nice course. I think it was only me and Cassio maybe in that course. I don't remember now exactly. But you convinced Cassio to take the course as well. And then our third interaction in 1996, back in 1996, was that before I actually went to Berkeley, Jair invited me to go to his apartment, his beautiful apartment. You know, we should go there and check it out. It's really impressive. You know, you can play soccer in the living room. It's really amazing. But so then I went there, and then he gave me two things. So he gave me, you know, a small container with jam, I think. And he told me, okay, hand this to Alan Weinstein. You know, I said, okay. And also a letter and a picture. And the picture was a picture of, you know, Luisa as a baby. You know, now here's Luisa. You know, she's not a baby anymore. And I don't know what the letter said. But so I just took everything. And then in my first chance I had, I gave this all to Alan. It was, you know, in 10:15 one day. And obviously this was also my first interaction with Alan that, you know, later we developed this relationship that was obviously really important for me too. But, you know, the first move, you know, the first touch was basically simulated by Jair. So he's been very, very supportive throughout the years. We've kept in touch all along. And you know, many people already praise his generosity and everything. So I agree with all that. And right now, I see Jair every month at least. You know, so we have a working seminar on geometric mechanics that Paolo organizes. And Jair, obviously, is a central figure in these meetings. It's very informal. So usually he comes, he just throws all his ideas, you know, very generously. And I think it's been very productive and very good for some young people here, too. So thanks, Jair.
I'd like to say a few words. There is some cake outside, and it has been too long the day, but I cannot refrain. I accept very humbly this thing, just with one condition, is that everybody have a lot of fun. That's the only condition. And our visitors, that some of them just arrived today, I wish they have a wonderful stay in Brazil. I'm really emotional with that. I repeat, the only condition is that everybody should have fun. I should say that my generosity comes out of pretended generosity, because I don't know how to do things. So I throw questions around in the hope that some people will like it and cite me, you know, somehow. That's the way I have been surviving the last 4 years in math. That's because I just don't know how to do things well. And that's maybe a strategy that some young people can take advantage of sometimes. See, so Clodoald is an example. I mean, Clodoald was very generous when he mentioned, because you know, those the young people now are driving Ferraris and, you know, big cars, and I have my small, you know, Volkswagen bug, you know, little things, and I'm very proud of the young generation in Brazil that is doing such a great thing. And I think geometric mechanics, I mean, will have a big future here in many places. And at this moment, I should really mention my acknowledgement and my thank to, first of all, to my family. Without them, I would be nothing. So that's, of course. And then, the patience of the people that have survived my dealings with bureaucracy and things at the university, at LNCC, at FGV. I have the coordinator here that he knows what I'm talking about. So the support and generosity of the people behind me, you know, has been great. And also my friends abroad, you know, were not for the help from people from Spain and Argentina and Russia or Ukraine, whatever, because they someday we never know what's going to anyway, and you know, all Latin America and U.S. and particularly this meeting, I mean, I was caught in the surprise. I would not expect. I mean, I would never be prepared to such a thing. It was not the my intention, my idea. And it's actually, it's not 65, and it's not this month, but they sort of put me in this. No-go situation, and I'm so happy that you guys are here. And so, I mean, have fun. I probably forgot a lot of things. I mean, to thank my mentors. Hildeberto was my first mentor. You know, I was 17, and, you know, he was a master's student at PUC, and he was teaching me, you know, very basic things at the time. So, I mean, Alberto, to Alan, Zalogwain, and also Jerry. And at this point, I should also really thank Alison and Mark Gauthier for bringing Mathieu here for the wonderful talk of yesterday. And Jerry is somebody that is also behind, you know, forever within us for his, you know, way of doing things. And we all learn from him. So what else I can say? You know, have fun. And I should mention, I don't know if the IMPA staff is here, but I mean, they have been awesome, you know. And we should really give a clap to them in the end of the meeting, because if they're not here, I mean, they're just great. So, well, mainly I would like to thank Paula for all her effort. You know, I know how it is, how to run. A meeting like that. So thank you all, and have fun with the cake.